I'll take like a screenshot of this front end here, and then I'll head over to my code editor to cursor here, of course. I might use the thinking version. Also, I'll paste in that image. All right, I want to create a mobile app with React Native. Home screen that shows currently active, uncompleted daily missions, screen for managing daily missions, screen for adding a new mission. Good, so it is done as it seems. Let's accept all and let's run npm start here. And let's again open it on the iOS simulator. No active missions, but I also got an error here. Maximum update death exceeded. Looks like this app has an infinite loop error related to the home screen. But let's see if things work now. If I restart npm start, okay, the error is gone. So now we got this starting screen, got the manage screen, and I can switch. I can't really reach that button down here, and I got explore. And I guess that is a relic from the starting setup. This is not related to this app. If I press this plus button and I can barely reach it, I go to this new mission screen. I can enter a mission title. Let's see, test, testing, click create mission. Okay, I go back to no active missions, and it's not added here either. The app is not working though, and the UI is, well, it looks the way it probably would look if I had created it, which is not a good sign. And even I would have probably done better. The app's starting without errors, but it's not working the way it should. I can barely reach the plus button on the manage screen because the tab bar is in the way. I won't even mention that the app doesn't look good because I don't want to put too much information in here. I just want to fix like the most obvious problems here. Okay, so let's see. Let's reload this. So now I got just two tabs, which is better. The plus button is also reachable. And if I now add this, good, good, good. So it fixed all the problems here, which is really good. I mean, we still have like a problem with that title. Can I edit it? I can toggle whether it's active or inactive, and I can delete it. Of course, the styling is still not great. So definitely quite a lot of things I want to fix and change. The app seems to work as intended now, but the UI looks horrible. The stack of non-highlighted missions also isn't really a stack of overlapping items. Make it look more modern and cool. Let's see what we get. Let's see, let's reload. Yes, the title is no longer hidden by the dynamic island. Instead, now it's cut off. And I'm not sure if this has a modern, cool look. It's really a difficult look. This, I'm not too sure. And I pressed it by accident, but the plus button is gone. It looks like there is an invisible plus button somewhere. Like if I press here, occasionally this will open up. This looks awful. And the plus button on the manage screen seems to be invisible. Let's reload. Okay, tab bar looks bad. This button looks bad, like a square jammed into a circle. It looks a bit better, mainly because it's darker. I still can't edit items. Boy, that looks horrible. It looks a bit better, but many things are still broken, do look bad. The tab bar is not dark as the rest of the app. On the new screen, the input elements also seem to have a white background or something like that. Title also still is a bit cut off at the top. So the header is still broken, at least looks like it, but I'll not worry about that right now. The rest looks better, the plus button, not sure about that placement. I somehow have the feeling that we, okay, that is not fixed. Okay, now we have a stack of overlapping items, but now we can't access them. Yeah, I only see test 3 here, and does not look like I can get access to the other items. Still, the styling is also not perfect. Like this blue gray thing here, I'd rather have it all gray. Still doesn't look great. Fix the position of the plus button. The styling on the new mission screen is broken. See the attached image. And I did attach the image here. It should be consistent with the dark look of the rest of the app. Reload the app here. That is still broken. The new mission screen still looks broken. The inputs need a dark background. What? For one, this does not make sense to navigate into this folder. You are already in that folder. And why would you want to install Expo Router? It is already part of this project. No reason to install Expo Router. It's already part of the project. Yeah, I expected this to actually go better. Finally, I'll ignore the fact that this is still white. It looks better than what we had before. Oh, but now I can't enter anything. It just overrides whatever I'm typing in both inputs. I'll start a new chat. I can't enter anything into the input fields of the new screen. Okay, let's restart again. I still can't enter anything. Yeah, sure, I guess this is not a command that will delete my system. I'm really not sure if it will be successful with these commands it's running here, but sure, have fun. Gosh. I'll at least try to get this to work here. Let's see. I'll open a new chat, I guess. On the home screen, I want to be able to click the stack to expand it. Just take a screenshot. Add that here. And let's see what that gives us. But it really looks like we're in that phase again where it's just doing weird stuff, where it's entering this cycle. Like here, I'm not sure why it's using cat to inspect content of a file. The file's there, it could just open it in my IDE, I guess, but sure. Okay, good news, good news. I'm running out of time, but this is now working. To be very honest, this stack here looks horrible, not the way I want it to look, but I can expand and collapse it. A lot of things about this app are broken, like the inputs here. I would have to dive into the code myself to debug that. I can't edit the items here. So there are many things that are not working the way it should. The UI is also still, could be better. So I failed miserably, or should I say AI failed miserably. And by the way, you can watch the full length VOD of the entire live stream if you want to. I uploaded it, link is below this video. And there you can see it in all its glory. But as you'll see there, and as you saw here, AI failed me. It did not build the app I asked it to build. And I did ask it to build a relatively simple React Native Expo-based mobile app where users should be able to manage daily missions, daily tasks they want to complete. And I wanted to have one screen where they can view all the currently active tasks and mark them as completed for the day, one screen for managing all tasks and marking them as active or inactive, and one screen for adding a new task. And when I finished the live stream, because I had to go after 2 hours, I got an okay-ish looking app, definitely not awesome, with quite a few bugs. Most importantly, unfortunately, the AI forgot that users should be able to edit tasks, and the add task form broke during the process of enhancing the app. It would reset the text inputs with every character a user would type, so that was not great. I also want to be very clear, using AI only for building an app, as I tried to do it here, so where I did not manually edit the code or write parts of the code, that's typically not my way of using AI. This was just an experiment. As I've said, it's a useful assistant and I use it as an assistant normally. But here I wanted to try relying only on AI, because I've read all these posts that you could build entire applications with just AI, that developers are done for, that you could build this amazing app with just two prompts and then basically one-shot or two-shot the solution. I wanted to give that a try. That was my idea here. AI is useful. I'm using Cursor and Sonnet
3.7, 3.5, or other models as assistants, they can be very helpful as coding assistants. However, I've also said it before, you should not solely rely on those AI tools because that might put you on the wrong side of the AI skill gap, but I talked about this in a separate video. I'll not repeat it here. So don't rely on it, but use it. That's my recommendation. Has been my recommendation, still is my recommendation. But I just wonder, I see all these people on X mostly that just build amazing stuff with one prompt, two prompts, 30 minutes, 1 hour, and they got amazing apps that did not require any code input at all. And I wonder, was I just unlucky? Maybe. Maybe I was unlucky. Maybe there also is more to it. Maybe building a good-looking landing page that has no functionality is not the same as building an entire application. And this was not even a complex application that I tried to build here. But still, it's more complex than just a landing page without any content behind it. Now, I am aware there are people that are building entire games with just AI, and I can't judge how much manual code input was required here, if they got lucky, if it's maybe a task AI is better suited to do because they were using technologies and libraries that maybe have been around for a bit longer than the most recent version of Expo, though in my app I don't think I used any super new Expo features. So whatever it is, I know there's all this hype whenever a new model is released and what you can do with it and that developers are done for. And surprise, like everything in the internet, you should take it with a grain of salt. You never know what the motives of someone are that's sharing how they built an amazing app in 30 minutes. And of course, people also might simply get luckier or might have better prompting skills than I did. Though you can watch the entire video. I'm not sure if my prompts were that bad or unclear or overloaded with information. And well, also, I thought those AI models got so much better. So shouldn't they be able to handle more complex prompts? Either way, my prompts weren't even complex. But yeah, there's that. AI, as I've said before, is useful, is there to stay. You should use it. But if we talk about AI replacing developers entirely and English being the new programming language, or human language in general being the new programming language, the programming language of the future, maybe at some point, though I don't feel we're there yet, I really don't feel like that, because if you need to have perfect prompts, if you need a deep understanding of how to interact with the AI, and if you then still need luck to get the right results, if that's the case, I rather stick to programming languages and a process that is more or less deterministic and where I know that I can achieve a certain outcome with a certain input. So that's my two cents on that, but definitely let me know what your experience with AI has been. Have you tried building something similar with just AI, and were you more successful than I was here, or did you encounter similar scenarios and problems? Definitely let me know. Have a great day. Bye.